Hey, how's it going, everybody? This is Frozen GFX, and I'm back again with the Town of Light. This is part 5, as we continue to find what's going on in this crazy, insane asylum called Charcot. We saw a lot of disturbing things before, and I kind of don't know what to do with it, man. Some things have kind of stayed in my mind. Renee has been treated awfully, and it's just... it's just bad overall. I booted up the game and it started me here. Looks like Charlotte, the doll, is on the wheelchair getting sunbathed. Let's just find out what's going on. Memories. I don't know, man. What do I do? She's not really talking. She's not really doing anything. Can I do something, please? Anything at all would be beneficial. Oh! It's a white screen. Maybe it's loading on me. Oh, something's happening. Am I the freaking doll? Oh, they're reeling me into some scary stuff right now. Oh gosh. Dude, what's happening right now? Who is pushing me? I don't like the sounds. Oh my god. It's turning by itself right now. What? Oh, that's that dude. No, get away from me. Don't do nothing. Oh my god, what is he gonna do to me?
I didn't do anything. I only obeyed orders.
Oh my god.
I only obeyed orders.
Don't leave me alone with this guy.
Oh no.
Please, no, where are we going?
She loves us, even though we're bad.
I didn't do anything.
What's going to happen?
I only obeyed orders.
It's a kid. Oh my god. I can't believe they're allowing this to happen. This is not right. What am I waiting for? Get me out of here, please. Can I move? Huh? Oh my god, what are they doing? What did you do to her? This is not right. What the hell's happening? Can I run? Can I leave? I can move. I'm getting out. I'm good. No. No, he's moving me in. Oh my god. I can't move. What? Oh no. Is this... what is this? Oh my god. No. What are they doing? I hope to God this is not electroshock therapy. Oh God. The faces, man. This is insane. Get me out of here, please. What? Don't hold my mouth. Oh my god, they're gonna shock me. Oh my god. They're putting the thing in my mouth so I could brace. Do not. Please, come on, man. Oh my god, he has a butt. Oh my god. I want to leave. Oh Jesus. This is not going to be good. This is not going to be good. I have a fear, like I have a reoccurring nightmare like this. This is not right. Please, 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 no, 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 no! He's pressing the button. This is ridiculous. They freaking shocked her, man. That is not cool. Oh my god, man. You guys don't understand. You know, since I was a child, I had a reoccurring dream that I woke up strapped to a bed where they were about to do that. The freaking electroshock. Oh, did not see that. And I was just playing this first person. The heck with this, man. Destroy it. Jesus. Alright, let's move on. The hell do we do? No, it's not what I want. Oh, man. Okay.
What was that doctor writing, sitting at his desk?
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, right there, right? Okay, what's up?
7th September, 1938. The patient frequently indulges in recriminations expressed in an explosive tone of voice. This morning she threw away the milk, saying it was full of urine, spittle, and all the other filth.
Oh, disgusting.
Crazed, she hears voices. They order her about. She says she heard children singing. They were imprisoned in a school. 20th January, 1939. Mutistic, groggy, pays no attention to anything. When questioned and stimulated, she starts crying and weeping. At other times, she laughs. 1st June.
Well, of course, you're
apathetic, eats very little. She refuses to be touched.
Yeah.
Doesn't respond. Passes her time in the park. The cooks report that she sits on a bench in front of the kitchens. 14 October. Impulsive once again. This morning she asked for 2 eggs to make zabaglione, but the moment she was given them, she threw them away. Excited, uproarious, slightly confused, she strips off. 8th December. Tied to bed for 15 days.
What?
High-spirited, tends to make witty comments and use vulgar words, laughs hysterically, masturbates. The nurses report that about 2 weeks ago she remained in the showers on her own and didn't want to leave. They report that when they took her away, she swore at them and then hit out at them and bit them. 2 nurses had to be treated for their injuries. Since then, they've kept her tied to the bed. Transferred to the semi-agitated ward. From the care of Dr. B to the care of Dr. C.
Oh,
I was with Amara in the showers. My memories terrify me. They're not real, are they?
Oh my god. I just realized it. What they are documenting, things that I've done which I've already seen memories of with Amara and other things. Oh my god. I was with Amara in the showers. My memories terrify me. They're not real, are they? Oh, I hope to god they're not. Oh, man. They strapped her down for 15 days in a bed. That is ridiculous. Memory is what you are, whether it's real or not. But your memories can lie to you. Oh, I don't know. Oh, man. Oh. I'm... I'm gonna do this one. Yeah, they're just a figment of my imagination. Oh, this horrible stuff. I hope it was just a figment.
15th December. Dr. C. Patient notes. The abnormality of her psychic state has induced her to lead a life which is irregular and tends towards delinquency. A fickle and flighty character, she abandons her household duties at intervals and dabbles in occasional prostitution.
Whoa.
Delinquency? Prostitution? Renee? It seems so strange, unreal. It can't be true. And Tamara? She loved us and she would tell us everything.
Oh man, that's
right. She wouldn't hide anything from us. Her mental deficiency makes her deaf to the reprimands of her family. She has shown suicidal tendencies.
Oh man.
She was brought to the ward yesterday, agitated and vociferous. Treated with cortisol. 2 injections a week for 5 weeks. The therapies remove the light for a short while, but also all will, desire, and hope.
The therapies remove the light for a short while. Oh man, so that's the shock treatment? The important thing was to keep us quiet. To a certain extent that we're trying to make you feel better. You were lost souls. The therapy was terrible and painful, but they were treatments. The only ones that existed. I can't justify that, man. That is... Oh, man. This is such a difficult thing to get through. The therapies remove the light for a short while, but also all will, desire, and hope. They were not trying to make me feel better. You can't inflict pain on someone and think that they're just going to be okay. I mean, at that time, I guess, they were the only ones that existed. That doesn't make it right, though. Alright. Let's do it.
It was torture, but you couldn't refuse it. No one explained anything to us. No one tried to make us understand. We were like animals on a stock farm.
Yeah. You were too many, and they were too few. It was impossible to do otherwise. They also had their nightmares within these walls. They didn't know what to do with you. That's not an excuse. You were damn souls dangerous. Ought to have taken care of you. Man, I don't like these answers. It was torture, but you couldn't refuse it. No one explained anything to you. Yeah, no one tried to make us understand. You were... Oh, man. I feel like I'm just trying to give them an excuse of what they did. Oh, you were too many and they were too few. It was impossible to do otherwise. That doesn't make it right. I'm so conflicted by this. I'm gonna go pee. Oh man.
2nd June. After a long period of calm and improvement, the patient is very agitated today and vehemently refuses to submit to a gynecological examination.
Oh, no one,
she swore and cursed those who generated her, flailing her arms and hitting out. The patient, according to reports by Dr. B, has been subjected to periodic checkups since she had a spontaneous abortion about 2 years ago in her 3rd month of pregnancy. Conception occurred after she had sexual intercourse with a stranger who sneaked into the hospital park.
No, it was the dude.
In the charges filed at police headquarters in Volterra. A copy of which is attached to these clinical notes. ES therapy. Spontaneous abortion? It's not true, I'm certain. How could I have invented things if I didn't even know what they were doing to me?
I cannot get over this. This is ridiculous, man. It really happened. They made you abort, but it was illegal, and so they had to write that it was spontaneous? That's a lie. What is written here might be false or the wrong way of looking at things. Perhaps Renee didn't know. You can't be certain You know that, don't you? Yeah, man. We had a memory that that male nurse took advantage of her. But then can we trust our memories? Because can we even trust these people? These people didn't even send out letters to her mother or have the letters delivered to her from her mother. This is putting me in a very strange predicament. I can understand how seriously I guess messed up Renee is or was because of the things that happened to her, but could she have just imagined these things and she is in fact out of her mind? Are these people really the enemy? I mean, it seems as such, but we just don't know, man. And okay, yeah, that's a lie. What's written here might be false or the wrong way of looking at things. Maybe we're looking at things the wrong way. We have a one-sided view, but we are the character. I believe we are the character. I'm going with this one.
13th June. The nurses report that after having received her mother's letter, she fell into a state of great mental confusion.
What?
She threw her soup over another inmate because she was very anxious, and she punched a nurse. Impulsive, lashes about her. She rails against the doctor in vulgar terms while he is examining her, lashes out and spits. Block all correspondence so as not to give the patient further reasons to become agitated. 20th August, tied to bed.
Again.
The nurses report the patient becomes highly agitated after the visit of a relative or family friend.
That guy.
2 days later, she still shouts ceaselessly that he commands her, that she must obey and harm herself, and that she is not Charlotte. All visits forbidden. Constrained to bed and intensification of ES therapy until we achieve results.
Electric
no contact
shock.
With the exterior. In that way, no one knew what was happening within these walls.
Oh my god. Human misery was thrown in here, locked away to make the world forget about you. The people who were in here were no longer human beings as far as society was concerned. The important thing was to keep you quiet. You don't remember what happened when the letters arrived. How can you judge? God knows how much suffering they spared you. What? This is harsh, man. I don't like any of these things, but I'll go with A.
3rd March. Alert, correct attitude, replies when questioned. The nurses report that the patient is calm. She washes and looks after herself. She affirms the existence of a certain Amara. She says that Amara is a patient who disappeared when she was moved to this ward. No confirmation. Probably a regressive hallucination. Evaluate transfer. Amara invented by me? That's not possible. She was there. I know she was there. I feel it. She must have left traces somewhere.
Oh man, we're on a search to find out. I can't get over that thing. To find if Amara really existed. This is something else, man. Look at that thing. Why is the music like that? Alright guys, I'm just about my 20 minute mark here. This has been difficult to handle. I was faced with something that was a real nightmare of mine in the childhood, and I just experienced it firsthand in first person view in a game. And I'm very uneasy at this point. Those questions, what is real? Were their memories real? Were what they're writing down, is that real? This is messing with me, man. I gotta find out what's gonna happen next, man. And I hope you do too. So please, please stick around for the next part. I want to thank you for joining me. If you like what we do, please subscribe. Hit that like button. We do this for the love of video games and We just want to share our love with you guys. So, again, thank you so much for playing along with me. I'm Frozen GFX. Have a great day.